I'm here with Mario Soto. He's a person that's very important in every fighter's life. He's not a trainer, he's not a coach, he's a sports psychologist. And I caught up with him to talk about the Olympic Games, London 2012. What should athletes know? What should they do and not do? Check it out. Athletes from all over the world are going to the Olympics.
Right.
They're gonna have women throwing themselves at them. They're gonna have sponsors. They're gonna have someone say, hey, try this drug, or whatever they're gonna have over there. Some wanna make it and some will do anything to make it. How do they handle all the pressure?
Well, that's a great question. Well, with all the testing, especially at the Olympic level, I think you're probably going to have less temptation than more. If they were doing it, they're probably going to do it early on and then taper it out so it's not in their system. But, you know, the Olympics is all about opportunity. And I would like to think that their hunger and their desire to make all those dreams come true won't take what has to happen, because if you're not successful in the Olympics, all these other things don't fall into place. You know, I sometimes
get help. Do the Olympics get help?
Yes. Yeah. Once they qualify for the Olympic team, there is a staff of sports psychologists who come from Colorado Springs that go there and they help them out.
But you got.
I could see a lot of athletes, boxers or wearing boxes or boxers that are just happy they made the team and, oh, I'm already going to be part of the Olympics. But then there's those that are, I'm going to go and win gold medal. That's a difference too. That's a difference some of those athletes.
One thing that most people don't know about the Olympic experience is that there's only three people who get the medal. And you have thousands of athletes who go to compete. So that means 90%+ of those athletes, for that experience that they're there, it's a very depressing moment in their lives.
Yeah.
So you're in Olympic Village, and it is like, oh my God, somebody died.
Yeah.
Because they went there for 4 years of preparation, and it didn't happen.
U.S. basketball team to the Olympics. Normally you have one star in a team. In boxing, it's an individual sport. Judo, yeah. Individual, taekwondo. Michael Phelps in swimming. Here you have Kobe, LeBron, Durant. So many superstars. What's the key in a team sport, unlike an individual sport, for them to be successful?
Wow. That's a great question. Well, fortunately, they have arguably one of the best coaches, one of the best team coaches in the history of the sport, in Krzyzewski. And he, more than anybody, really preaches the sense of team, what it takes to create a strong team and a bond. From the success he had with the last Olympics, it's about the three letters up here, not the name on the back. And I think with the leadership on that squad, guys having come back, having won the gold, knowing what it takes, with LeBron having won a world championship now, this is icing on the cake for him. His ego is now fulfilled, and now it's about, let's go and represent the country. I think his job's going to be easy. I really do. I don't think they're going to have any challenge at all.
Of course not. I looked at their brackets. It's comedy, and it's going to be good. They're going to win every game by 60 points.
I think they will. But I mean challenge in the sense of getting everybody to play for each other.
Because a few years before that in the Olympics, total failure, they had the bronze because they went out partying, and they stayed on a boat, and it was the year with Allen Iverson.
And they were saying that all those guys were all about endorsements. What's wrong with me? How come I'm not getting more playing time? How come I'm not getting more camera time? How come I'm not getting more stories told about me? You know, all those guys have healthy egos. I think they're together for the right amount of time. And I think I remember somebody saying that, you know, had they been around a little longer, things started getting ugly and started chippy a little bit. So, you know, it's timing. It really is. But I think these guys will be fine.
An athlete is way too confident, because heart and hard work will only take you too far. They don't have the skill, but how do you deal with that?
Interesting. There's a man whose name was mentioned earlier, I will not repeat his name, who has that issue, and the guys who are working with him have explained that to me. Now, you can only help somebody who wants to get helped. You can't push the person and force them into seeing what their issues are.
But what athlete that's a superstar would want help? I'm not crazy. I don't need a psychologist. I'm the man.
No, because it's about getting better. And if there's anybody who out here thinks that they are it, their next fight, they've lost. They're going to lose. Guarantee it.
Are you going to go spend time with the Olympic team at all? Are you going to go to London and work with athletes?
No, I had three athletes that I was all hoping were going to go to London, and I was going to be a part of that. And unfortunately, all three of them either had injuries, in the case of my equestrian horse rider, horse went bad, and then my other athlete didn't qualify in the World Games. So, not this year.
Horse went bad? Can you replace a horse?
Not. It would be like, in this sport of equestrian jumping, it would be like saying, you know what, Michael Jordan rolled his ankle, so I'm going to take this young man now to take his spot.
Now you're going to get killed.
I can't even grab the rim. You know, so no, it's, and that sport is fascinating because it's not just the rider, it's the horse as well.
You deal with professional athletes, boxers, NBA players, NFL players.
Yes.
What's the most common thing you see with athletes that you spot right away? Okay, I can help them with ABC. What is it?
I don't think there is a most common because everyone's an individual. Everyone's different. This person's strengths might be this person's weakness. This guy might have a confidence issue. This guy might all over himself in a locker room because he gets so nervous.
Happened to some guy in the ring twice. He knows. Then there's your other kid here in the other gym.
Some kids throw up in the dressing room right before a fight.
Yes. Yes.
So how do you deal with that? Okay, let's say I'm a kid that throws up before a fight. What do you tell me?
Try and put your attention on what really matters, what's important. You should never be worrying about anything. You need to put your attention on what you need to do. Trust in your preparation.
What if I have a terrible upset stomach before every fight?
Go use the bathroom.
That's it?
Go use the bathroom. Get it out of your system. You know why? Because it means you care. It's all right. It's a matter of understanding what it is. When I work with kids, tell them you got butterflies in the stomach. That's right. Everyone's got them. Teach them how to visualize. Teach them how to fly in formation.
I don't understand.
You got butterflies, they're all over the place, they're all messing up, they're scattered all over the place.
So in your mind?
In your mind, visualize teaching them how to fly in formation like a flock of birds. Simple little thing.
Let me piggyback on something Mario said earlier, going back. Mike Tyson used to beat 90% of his opponents before the fight through intimidation.
He's already scared of him.
He's got a fight on August 3rd. I said, if you're prepared and you do the work, whatever happens, happens. Because one thing you want to do, especially in this sport, you want to win the crowd. The crowd's not fickle. The crowd's pretty honest.
But I heard they hate Americans overseas. I talked to Olympians, and they said wherever we compete overseas, we get booed.
Why? Of course. Why? Because we're the standard bearer.
We're the country everybody wants to be.
Yes.
We're
yes.
Big, bad boy.
Yep.
Yeah, and you know what? You wear the letters of your country,
everybody's gonna hate you right overseas.
You go there for your own purpose.
I'm going to the Olympics. Should I wear Mexico on my chest? Should I go to swap meet by a bunch of t-shirts and hats? Yeah, that's what I should do.
Well, here's what you do. Make sure you go to the wrestling events because there's a kid from Santa Ana who's wrestling from Mexico. So go support him.
Abner Mars was from Hawaiian Gardens and he fought from Mexico.
Oh, okay, there you go.
Panchito Bojada.
Yeah?
There's been a few. Hector Lopez, he got a silver medal. Rest in peace, Hector Lopez. 1984 Olympics, he got a silver medal in the Olympics representing Mexico. But he grew up in LA, saw his dad. Yeah. Abner Mars, Panchito Bojada, there's been a few. Okay. What's his name, Molina Kids?
Yeah, Oscar Molina this year, you probably win a medal. He's very talented. His brother represented the United States.
Nice.
And I went with him down the street and we got robbed at gunpoint and they stole his Olympic watch.
Yeah, Carlos Martinez, actually. 96 Olympics. Carlos Martinez, my dad used to train him. He grew up in Oxnard and trained in Oxnard and represented Mexico in the Olympics.
Because they know they want the better athletes.
Yeah.
Now, but, you know, it's just easier because if you grew up in the States, maybe you'll be a little more privileged. And maybe physically.
Your mom or your dad
from
Mexico and you can represent their country.
Yes, and that's true of any of the countries. Yes.
Any other countries too?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
So in conclusion, Mario Soto, any message to Olympians who are in London getting ready, if they're watching?
Sure, I'll say this for anybody. Trust in your preparation, do all that you can do, and don't let the pressure of the moment overwhelm you. Go do your thing. Because that's why you sacrifice 4 years of your life.
So there you have it, Mario Soto with advice to the athletes going to the Olympics. Stay tuned for more. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Mike Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @SecBack.
Be